Aaron Rodgers. He's the fastest of 400 in NFL history.
Luckily, it wasn't your first one, so I can...
Yes, you can keep that day.
100, JJ threw in the stands.
I remember that.
200 was your first.
Who got three?
Ty did.
I remember that one.
Let's get to our Hall of Famer. It's Kurt Warner's top three presented by Volvo. Now, Kurt, of course, we talked about Jalen Hurts making his start with the Eagles. That warranted its own discussion, of course. But what are your top three quarterback storylines, other than that one, to watch in Week 14?
Well, I mean, I tell you what, MJ, we've got some great storylines. And one thing that I've realized being in the league and covering the league for so long is there's always something else to prove. So number three on my list is Ravens against Browns, Lamar Jackson against Baker Mayfield. Baker has a great game last week. Okay, let's see you do it again. Lamar Jackson, we know that he's the reigning MVP, but they've struggled a little bit this year. And so everybody's starting to ask, okay, was that just a fluke? Is this the real Lamar Jackson, or is last year the real Lamar Jackson? So also something to prove. Can't wait to watch this game. It's been a great matchup with one team really dominating each and every time out. They get the number three spot. Number two, Patrick Mahomes against the number two scoring defense in the league in the Miami Dolphins. And what makes this so interesting is that Miami loves to play man-to-man coverage. Now, if there's one team in the league and one quarterback in the league you don't want to play a bunch of man-to-man coverage against, it's the Chiefs and Patrick Mahomes. So, will Miami change up what they do? That is their MO. Or are they going to try to go man-for-man with all these weapons of Patrick Mahomes? And what does that look like? And on a little side note, rookie quarterback against best quarterback in the league. I know we don't play against the other quarterback, but you always know who's on the other sideline. And then number one for me is going to be that huge Sunday night matchup between the Bills and the Steelers. Big Ben against Josh Allen. Josh Allen may be coming off his best game as a pro. Big Ben may be coming off his worst game of the year. Huge playoff implications in this one. Can't wait to watch these teams and get a gauge of who these teams really are and where they stack up in the AFC.
Kurt, I can already feel sort of the tension culminating for that Steelers-Bills matchup. Because listen, Big Ben coming off his first loss of the season. Josh Allen, by the way, they've won 5 of the last 6 games. I love it. Kurt, thank you so much. And you guys at home, you know where to find Kurt, right? With the rest of the Game Day Morning crew, of course, Sunday at 9 a.m. Eastern on NFL Network. Let's take a little peek here at the AFC playoff picture, where the Browns hold the 5 seed at the moment, while the Ravens, their Tuesday night win has them right back in the hunt. Lamar Jackson is back, and listen, this team is playing with a massive chip. Actually, more of a boulder, really. But despite clinching the franchise's first winning season since 2007, Baker Mayfield and the Browns, they're still out here trying to prove themselves. This AFC North Divisional Battle is our Total Access Game of the Week.
Yes.
Willie McGinnis and James Jones, come on in. Or Sean Connery, as we were just mentioning.
All you need is some cognac and a pipe, man.
That's a whole other show. That's the after show. Willie, I could hear it in your voice earlier when we were talking about this matchup.
Yes.
This one runs deep because it's a divisional game.
Yep.
But playoffs are literally breathing down everybody's neck right now. What do the Browns need to do to get some respect against a division opponent who, by the way, they struggled with against in week one?
Absolutely right. And respect is the name of the game. I played in this division, and the Ravens and the Steelers are looked up as the big brothers. The Browns need to come in and take over and overthrow the big brother, okay? They got to be physical. They got to control the trenches. Don't get away from the running game. You got two of the best runners in the game. Control the trenches and run the football. But what we saw from Baker Mayfield in this passing game last week, they're going to have to continue to do. Throw the football effectively. Here's Baker Mayfield in the bunch formation. He's going to roll to his left. He is very, very good at moving the pocket, being accurate, especially when you flip it, the defender in his face, finding the window, the throwing to the correct receiver, and making an accurate throw down the football field. He's going to have to do this time and time again. Keep mixing it up, move the pocket from in the pocket. Now, here's a great pocket throw, okay? Watch this. He's going to drop back. He's in shotgun. Nobody's open. He does a great job of surveying the field. Nobody's open right here. Again, being very athletic, he's going to move the pocket just slightly to his right. He's still going to have a defender in his face, but he locates Higgins. Higgins does a great job of finding a small space. Look at the delivery. Look, he keeps them in play. He keeps them in play inside the field just to get his feet in the accurate tight window throw with tight coverage. You can high step, Baker, because you're making throws like this. You got to continue to make these throws, continue to throw the football, and make plays down the football field.
Bang, bang. I love it. He's out there dropping dimes. Bang, bang. And listen, I'm telling you right now, hey, the little brothers, the Cleveland Browns, was watching film of the Dallas Cowboys go out here and really manhandle this Ravens defense. This Ravens defense did not slow the Cowboys down at all, not in the run game, or not in the pass game. You have Kareem Hunt. You have Nick Chubb coming in the building. And they are ready to go to work. They watch the tape. And then for the receivers, you got these guys out there, Landry and them. They did not slow these guys down. You see the holes that Zeke is running through. You see receivers wide open on the football field. The Baltimore Ravens defense looked bad yesterday. And if they do not get it fixed with the little brothers coming in there, after the first quarter, hey, the little brother's going to be looking on the sideline like, we the big dogs now. They can't stop us. We're going to continue to run this ball down their throat. Willie, I know Bake threw that ball well last week, and I'm a fan of him, but run the air out of the football back.
So you're saying, James, don't worry about proving about that arm. Just do what works and do what's really killing him out there. I like it. I'm here for it. But I'm also on the side of Kurt Warner. Let's see you do it again, Baker. I like it. I'm here
for both
aerial attack and on the...
I can do that.
Get ready for a primetime showdown in L.A. The Patriots are chasing a playoff spot in the AFC, but the Rams have postseason hopes of their own. Thursday night football tomorrow, 7:30 p.m. Eastern. That's on Fox, NFL Network, and streaming on Prime Video. But let's get you to SoFi Stadium right now over in Inglewood, where we find Steve White. Welcome in, Steve. Good to see you, my friend.
Whitey.
Look at that. He's got the perfect perspective for the game tomorrow.
Well, I got the stadium to myself pretty much right about now, too, guys. But look, coming into this game, the Rams players said the one thing when they look at this Patriots offense and quarterback Cam Newton is they are starting to find their identity. And even though Cam is a multi-threat quarterback, they are looking at him as a runner. And this is where things really get interesting. New England has won four of its past five games. In each of those victories, they have run the ball at least 30 times. The one loss to the Texans, they ran it 24 times. We have seen Cam Newton in three of those victories throw for 118 yards or less. So again, New England's offense is rounding into a power run-based offense. So Willie, this is where I want to bring you in, especially when it comes to Cam Newton. Mm-hmm. When you look at what they're doing, because they're making no bones about it sometimes. They're just snapping it to him and they're letting him just quarterback, you know, student body right type action. When you see what they're facing this Rams defense, and what they're going to have to do with Newton as a runner and the way the Patriots lead blockers are getting after it, how can they stop him? And can the Patriots score enough points with Cam playing offense like this?
Well, I think when you're designing a game plan around Cam and you're personnel specific and game plan specific, you look at what the team doesn't do well. What is the Rams haven't done well since week 10? They haven't been able to stop the power running game. They're almost giving up 5 yards a pop, Steve. So if I'm game planning against a defense that's struggling against a power running team, I'm going to run the football. So the Patriots, yes, they're going to go in. They're going to run the football. They're going to use Cam. You mentioned it, and that was great analysis by you. He is a threat in every single play, whether it's pass or run. There's a run part to the play, which is if he's going out the back door, if it's a zone read, if it's a zone run pass, if it's a boot, whatever it is, that run option is incorporated within the offense because they know how deadly Cam can be with his legs. Now, as far as the design runs that they're going to go straight at you, they want to see if you can stop it. If you can't stop those type of plays, which the Rams have been struggling, not sideline to sideline, direct runs right at those smaller linebackers in the middle with Hollins and Young. They're going to go right at them. So look at what the Patriots done. Look at what the Rams have been struggling in and look forward to seeing a lot of those. The other thing that run game does, it keeps their offense for the Rams on the sideline because they're creating a huge gap in the time of possession. They're hogging and taking up most of the time and they're having consistent long drives.
Hey, Willie, one thing real quick that Brandon Staley said he has cautioned his defense about. If you see Cam running, you've got safeties coming up to make plays and guys stepping up against that run. Cam's one of those guys you can take two steps forward, take a step back, and pop the ball over your head, too. So he said they've really got to be cognizant of everything they're doing. But I'm glad you talked about the run game, because Cam, they use him on some of those inside zone runs as well. You don't see too many quarterbacks do that. But again, at Cam's size, he's somebody who can deliver a blow as well as take one.
Yep.
Do you guys remember the